Hey, what's going on, guys? What's going on? It's your homie, Volume 1, coming back here with another Romance of the Three Kingdoms episode. Today we are on Episode 3, and it's getting a little goofy here if you've been keeping track of, because Cao Cao is acting a goddamn fool. But that's just in his nature. We're going to see exactly how his nature is. It's not too kind, but it is kind, but it's also practical. It's hard to hate him for it, but it really is easy to hate him for it too. It's kind of a gray area when it comes up to Cao Cao and the way he likes to do things. I want to give a shout out to my boy Guan Yu, and a shout out to my boy Guan Yu right here. Boop, 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 boop. That's right. Shoot all the way, baby. So anyways, we're going to be hopping into it, and like I've done with the previous episodes, I just want to have a full disclaimer here that I do not know at all. Not at all. But I want to say that I know enough to explain some of the things a lot easier for people, you know. I have studied Romance of the Three Kingdoms unknowingly and unwittingly since I was 9 years old, and I'm 43 now, and it all started with Destiny of an Emperor for Nintendo. And then it went to Romance of the Three Kingdoms, Super Nintendo, Dynasty Warriors, Dynasty Warriors 2, Kessen, so on and so forth. And the books, and the animes, and all that. Like, I've read them all, I've done them all, I've seen them all, Red Cliffs, all that shit. But I'm here to help you learn about this little wonderful, crazy time. Pretty geeked about it, so. The song that you're listening to right now in the background is actually called Quan Yu's Mandate. And it's based on Guan Yu, dude. Shit's pretty sweet. But let's hop into this episode, dude. We're in episode 3. In the very first video that we did for episode 1, we listened to the theme song, but we ain't gonna be doing that anymore. We're just gonna be hopping right in, dude, and seeing the scoop. Alright, let's get this going. Like I said, if you like what you see, like what you hear, please subscribe, like, and subscribe. I'd love to have you back, dude. We're going to be learning about this whole thing. Every episode's like 46 minutes long. It's like 42 with the credits. And then there's 92 episodes, so we got a lot to go through here. I like smoking, so I won't be smoking up, so you're just going to have to deal with that. So let's learn about Three Kingdoms, dude. I want to say the last one we left our people, Cao Cao had some shit going on with Chen Gong, and they were on the run, dude. So let's go check and see how they're doing over here, dude. Let's get this going. Alright, guys. Alright. Ladies and gentlemen, Romance of the Three Kingdoms, Episode 3. From the 2010 series, and we're just gonna scoot right on through. Bow, bow. Turn it up for you. Yeah, we'll get some. We'll get that going. Here we go, episode 3. Oh yeah, when we last left everybody, dude, Cao Cao was a wanted man for trying to assassinate Dong Zhuo. He hooked up with his uncle, and his uncle was like, hell yeah, dude, I'm glad that you're here. I'm gonna bounce out to the fucking town, I'm gonna grab some hooch, and my helpers are gonna fucking slaughter a pig and have a feast. And Cao Cao's like, bet. So they're taking a nap, they hear the help talking about, let's tie him up before we kill him, blah, 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 let's get him going, we gotta surprise him, and Cao Cao thought that they were gonna be attacked, so Cao Cao came out of the fucking bedroom swinging, started chopping motherfuckers left and right, pap, 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 pap. Chen Gong started joining them as well, but they figured out that that's not what was happening, they were tying up the pig or the hog to slaughter for the feast, and they just, Cao Cao and Chen Gong just ran through this whole fucking household, dude. Super nuts. Oh. see him. Fuck. Buff wild crazy. Fucked up, guys. Killed your whole your uncle's servants, everybody. Man, woman, child, Cao Cao did not care. Damn, they killed every motherfucker up in there. Now they're bouncing out. Remember, I said the uncle left to go to town to get some fucking drink. And he's on his way fucking back, dude. He doesn't know any of this shit's happening. But they want to bounce before he comes up. Look at that bullshit, dude.
...不奉你，知错还杀！你， 你还有半点忠义之心吗？
什么？I'd rather betray the world than have the world betray me.
宁肯我负天下人，休叫天下人负我。
Chen Gong can't believe the words that he's hearing. Cao Cao is fucking crazy. He's not gonna let him. Not gonna let him burn.
Dong Zhuo,
恐怕我们得回去。要回哪里去？很抱歉。
为什么？此去城流还有几百里路，我们已经两天两夜都没吃没喝了。如果再这么走下去，我们非冻饿而死不可。哼，我还以为曹孟德良心发现，要回去安葬女工及其家人。东台兄不必太动感情，死者不可复生，而生者仍需肩负大业。他已经把吃的喝的都准备好了。 如果我们不回去，他不是白死了。走吧。伯父，不是阿瞒害了你，是这个乱世害了你啊！你的大恩大德，大仁大义，侄儿至死都不会。 伯父，曹操定会为你老人家报仇雪恨，举义讨贼，扩清天下。之后。 曹操大业有成，定会赐你丹书铁券，还要册封你为公侯，让你老人家的在天之灵永享万世香火。He's
trying to make amends for his bullshit.
听你这话，不像是逃亡的罪徒，倒像是明天的帝王。<笑>
孟台兄，人心叵测，世事难料，将来的事儿，谁说得定？行吧，心思已毕。
I'm just gonna sleep in the same room with a dead man, with a man I killed.
我已经十几天都没有吃过肉了。While
they're making some soup.
想什么呢？我在想我的那些个蛐蛐，他们。 但是你却抛弃了他们，跟着我走了，啊？是为什么呢？是不是说明我曹操比那些蛐蛐强点啊？所以说，在乱世当中，只有强者才配谈仁义，弱者只有配抛弃。哼！
哈哈 ，I fucking love Cao Cao. This actor is perfect.
当初在中牟县的大牢里，应该一刀把我的脑袋砍下来，装到坛子里，送到京师，到董卓那儿去，换几个小钱儿。是。当初我还以为你是英雄豪杰，所以我不惜舍生忘死。 抛家弃官跟随于你，今天我真不知道你是忠义之士，还是奸恶之徒。You
don't know by now. You don't know. I love that laugh, dude. Fucking A, I love that laugh.
公台兄。I
want to hear it again.
公台兄。 自古以来就是大奸似忠，大伪似真，忠义和奸恶都不是从表面就能看得出来的。也许你昨天看错了我曹操，可是今天呢，你又看错了。但是我仍然是，我从来都不怕别人看错。It's
not my fault you fucked up who I was. That's what he's saying. Not my fault. It's not my fault you thought I was a good dude. Who the fuck do you think I'm a good dude?
行了，肉，吃吧。
Now Cao Cao's sleeping, dude. There's a chance, homie. There it goes. Now you gonna rid the world of Cao Cao? Like you don't hear that? This would have changed history. This right here would have changed the game. How you still didn't wake up with that? He lost his very first follower. A man who thought he was honorable.
Yao sha bian sha ma, he bi you yu. Gao de zhi hen tong ku.
Now Cao Cao hooked up with his fucking, his pops, who will come into play way later on. But his pops is gonna, this word's gonna pop off here.
屠戮忠良, 善行非礼, 亵渎朝纲, 金城外, 各路诸侯, 刺史, 将军, 眼看着董卓, 独霸京师, 权倾天下, 哪一个不是, 又气, 又怒, 又嫉妒, 而乱世, 正是英雄辈出之时, 所谓, 时势, 走英雄，而想举义起兵，成就一番大业。儿啊，董贼势大，只恐一时难以为敌呀。而在京城时，曾经屈身示于董贼。据我观察，董贼所倚仗的，就是一支西凉军。而西凉军虽然骁勇，贼首董卓。 却是并无远见与卓识。此人独霸洛阳，手握朝纲，却只懂得奸淫烧杀掠夺，胸中并无大志。<笑>儿啊，我已把曹氏家产全部变卖，得金25,000，你可用它招募兵勇。
His dad already fucking did that shit.
不够，远远不够。成大事者不可无计，却又不完全在于钱。首先是人，得以英雄豪杰，胜过十万精英。So
this is where he fucking recruits some bad motherfuckers here. The people that are gonna be his core people from the get-go, dude. Ready? Here we go.
在下魏国人士乐进，自闻谦，特来投拜曹操，共襄大业。在下巨鹿人士李典，字曼城，愿效于曹公鞍前马后，不必俘获，生死相随。
夏侯渊、夏侯惇、夏侯王、夏侯惇，特来投奔曹兄，共同抗敌。大伙儿快坐吧，咱们从长计议。
大哥，袁绍派人送信来，说他已从魏国起兵，沿途邀集了18镇诸侯，欲讨伐董贼，力请大哥前去入盟呢。
And who did? Yuan Shao. So now, Cao Cao has recruited Li Dian, Yu Jian, Chu Ho Dun, Chu Ho Dun, or yeah, Chu Ho Wan, Chu Ho Dun, his cousins, Cao Ren, who is his other cousin, Cao Hong, right here, who's his younger brother, and there's other people involved as well, right? And Yuan Shao has put out the fucking word and invited all the goddamn lords of the country to come in and take over Dong Zhuo. Because Dong Zhuo is just fucking raping, pillaging, killing, abusing the emperor, blah, 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 blah. So now they're going to have their very first sit down and council and bullshit. So here
we go.
Cao Ren，就占了大半个天下。我看董卓和他的西凉军，岂不是弹指可灭吗？大哥，赶紧动身吧！弟兄们与你同去。大哥，兄弟，弟兄们愿跟你前往。大伙想想，这18镇诸侯原本都是各地枭雄，哪一个手里？ 没有几万兵马，我们就凭着这点家族子弟
怎么可能在盟军中占有一席之地？但是如果没有一席之地，就算你打败了董卓，我们又能得到什么呢？这些诸侯原本就是要争官、争享、争城池，谁会把我们放在眼里？大哥真是有远见啊！董贼还没有灭掉，你就已经看到
攻城之后的事了。哎，think about what's the whole point？见微知著。那你说怎么办？难道我们不去入盟了吗？当然有，因为我已经给十八路诸侯准备了一份大礼，而这恰恰是十八路诸侯最要紧之物，它的价值胜过十万雄兵。大哥，什么礼物？
This is where he's going to try to pull some shit on everybody. A decree from the emperor.
Everybody. 凭什么号令天下？他们岂非名不正言不顺了吗？而我刚刚从京师出来，只有能够写出天子密诏。也就是说，只有有了我曹操，十八镇诸侯才算是名正言顺，盟军才算是奉天举义。大哥，
天子真的授予你讨贼诏书了吗？当然没有。<笑>不过我可以替天子拟一道诏书。矫诏啊，矫诏。对，假的，假的，有时候比真的还管用。So
he's gonna try to say that the emperor gave him some shit. And gave him permission to let's do this shit in the name of the emperor. Let's take over Dong Zhuo. He's gonna fake it though. So now the armies are all showing up right now, dude. All the lords, the 18 lords and shit like that. I mean, they all come with troops and shit. They all have troops and everything, right? They have provisions. They have money. They have this. So now all the head motherfuckers are showing up, dude. They had this big council meeting and take over Dong Zhuo. Cao Cao, Yuan Shao, Wan Shu, Sun Jian, Gong Song Zan, Kong Rong, Ma Tang. The who's who is everybody showing up to this motherfucking gala. And Yuan Shao is supposed to be the leader of this bitch because he's from, his family's been well known and they have the most land and they have the most money. And look who's showing up.
Sandy.
那就是陈六城，袁绍正在汇集各路诸侯，我们这就去入盟呗。去是去，大哥非与我不可。
Fucking Zhang Fei, come on now.
你有所不知，袁绍四世三公，名动天下，他所召集的十八镇诸侯。 个个都是刺史郡守之类的人物，任谁都比你哥哥的名头大。哎，咱不管这个，咱只要问问，在这些诸侯当中，可有像哥哥这样的汉王后裔吗？只怕没有。可有像哥哥这样的仁义君子吗？只怕也没有。这不就结了？大哥不做盟主，谁做呀？难道叫我张飞做吗？哼，我最怕这啰嗦事儿。
所以，进城之后，盟主是我大哥的，副盟主是俺二哥的，俺张飞嘛，就做个先锋将军。
好了，三弟，不可胡言，快快进城吧。
三弟啊，咱哥志大，岂在一时啊？还是赶紧进城吧。各路英雄既然已经到了城里，咱们也好早早的会会他。
走，大哥。
So now all these lords showed up with all their tens of thousands of troops. All their troops. And Liu Bei, Guan Yu, and Zhang Fei show up with all three of them motherfuckers. And they're like, alright, let's get this done. Let's make this bread. This is Yuan Shao, okay? Remember his face.
前置盛世啊，就是洛阳朝廷。
That's my tongue.
又何曾聚过这么多英雄豪杰呀？With
the long hair.
贼要是知道我等在此聚义，肯定会闻风丧胆。我等兵锋所向，破洛阳取董卓首级，朕如探囊取物啊！This
motherfucker who's an asshole is Wan Shu. This bitch. Can't remember these guys. I think this is Gong Song Zan. I don't think it's Sun Jian.
十八镇诸侯往这一站，这大半个江山就在我们的脚底下了。剩下那一小片江山，也是弹指可数。There's
Sun Jian, right there.
于，列位将军，此时此刻，我各路人马相加。 步军45万，骑兵9万，这比董卓的西凉军还多出2倍有余。如此强大的军力，何愁贼寇不灭？是啊，是啊，是啊，对，有道理，有道理，有道理。员工，各位将军。
在下有一言，我等既然是聚义会盟，必须先立位德高望重之士为盟主，统一号令，方可进军剿贼。说的对，是啊，我们都应该遵从盟主号令。原本初，四世三公，汉相后裔，门生故吏遍天下，贤德之声远播四海。在下的意思，请员工担当义军盟主。
我等遵奉号令，共同讨贼。非本初不可，
非本初不可，非本初不可。 Everybody just loves his ass for some reason.
既然主公有令，元谋只好奉命了。哎，站住！哦哦哦哦！尔等何人？
老大，快去叫袁尚出来接驾，我大哥前来会盲了。哎，你三弟，休得无礼。这位弟兄，请通禀一声。
就说平原刘备官员前来会，有什么？关什么？没听说过。What did he say？Lu what？关什么？没听说过。袁将军请你们了吗？天下兴亡，匹夫有责，何必要请？既然没请，就快快离去，啊！城关内都是群英聚义。
Fucking hey, Zhang Fei ain't playing nothing. Let's get a rewind on that bitch. Here comes Cao Cao.
想当初我父王司徒寿宴的时候，也是因为名位太低而被拒之门外。想不到今天这三位壮士和我同死遭遇，啊！<笑>在下刘备，有礼。敢问足下是？
骁骑校尉曹操。
你就是刺董的曹孟德？曹某未曾见过。
孟德兄刺贼一举，已经名扬海内，刘备深感敬佩。<笑>这位将军，你既没听过这三位壮士的大名，那你听说过我曹操吗？
曹公大名如雷贯耳。
在我刺董之前，和他们一样，也是无名之辈。你又怎么知道今天的无名之辈来日会不会名震天下？假如有一天，他们真的名震天下了。
你又会不会为今天的所作所为追悔莫及呢？曹公说的是，曹公说的是。三位，随我入关吧。多谢曹公。
And Cao Cao got the VIP access. Come on in, motherfuckers. Now watch this shit, dude. And Cao Cao showed up with 4,000 troops. But everybody knows Cao Cao because he's fucking tried to kill him straight up. And he's got a seat at the table. And watch them just ignore Liu Bei. Who do you think is going to like that? Nobody's not going to like that. Watch this shit.
公孙将军，马腾将军，曹某见礼了。好，这位将军请坐。孟德，请坐。
请。
Told everyone to take their seats, but look who's still standing there.
嗨！你们没有看见我哥哥在这里吗？
德，这三位壮士是你的人吗？倒也不是，我是在关前与他们相遇，当时守将正在为难他们，我顺便就把他们带进来了，都是末路英雄。
I like that. Heroes meet in unexpected ways. Doesn't that shit sound cool?
Oh.
It's cold-blooded.
来，三位，我给你们引荐一下。 这位就是咱们十八路盟军的盟主袁绍，袁本初将军。这位是
对不住，我实在是记不住你的名字了。禀元盟主，在下刘备，字玄德。这位是我二弟关羽，字云长。这位是我三弟张飞，字翼德。请问，足下是何出身？
Here we go. This motherfucker asked, can I inquire to your background? And Liu Bei is gonna take his dick out and show everybody how big it is right here.
足下是何出身？我是汉室宗亲，景帝之子，中山靖王刘胜之后。 请问，足下从何而来？现居何官爵？又以何事为业？刘备世居乡里，并无爵位，以织席贩履为业；二弟关羽，河北解良人士，以守门护院为业；三弟张飞，河北涿州人士，以卖酒屠猪为业。哼，一个织席贩履，一个看门护院。
One is a mat weaver, another a bodyguard, and the third is a butcher. Yeah, bitches.
可笑三个莽夫竟然在此大言不惭。
Zhang Fei was about to rip shit up.
一个堂堂帝王之后，能在大庭广众之下，天下英雄面前，将织席贩履。
卖酒屠猪说的如此泰然，可见此人心胸不凡呐。说的是，刘备，你此行来有何目的？
闻原本出传书海内，聚义讨贼，在下是来会盟的。哦，你有多少人马？
连我在内，三人三骑。
二弟关羽为马弓手，三弟张飞为步弓手。我兄弟三人一统生死，荣辱与共。我十八镇诸侯，引兵最少的也有15000，你们区区三人，也好意思与我们会盟？救火星，忠义为先，岂在人多？既然是皇族后裔，那就看座吧。谢座。
Look at this fucking seat. Dude, Zhang Fei ain't having it. Now watch these brothers stand right fucking guard behind his ass. And this whole time, watch Liu Bei's eyes. Every time you see him, look what he's doing and how calm and cool his demeanor is.
Wait. 但是我们师出无名，为什么呢？因为我们缺一道天子诏。如果我们没有天子诏，我们不就成了乱兵了吗？我们不就跟董卓一样无道了吗？可天子却掌控在董贼的手中，无法给我们此诏啊！我出洛阳之前。 天子亲手授予我一道密诏，召天下英雄入京擒王，除贼复国。十八镇诸侯，接诏。See,
he wanted everyone to bow to him. He liked that shit. He wanted to see it. He wanted to test it out.
贼臣董卓，篡国朝纲，秽乱宫廷，残害生民，祸国弑君。朕泣血守诏，召天下英雄率义军入京秦王，扩清寰宇，扫平奸贼，忠心大汉。诶，这诏有些不对呀、啊。
哪儿不对？
天子年幼，且又被董卓居于深宫。再说他也没见过臣下。
怎么会把此诏传给你呢？公路将军说的对，天子年方九岁，怎么能写出如此雄壮的诏书？啊！这诏书乃是我草草替天子拟的。
Everyone's like, "Oh, you motherfucker!"
请问公路将军，既然那董卓能把天子居于深宫之中，视如掌上玩物，我等为什么就不能视他如草芥，拿他来为我们所用？再说，曹某手中的诏书，哪一句不是天子想说而不敢说的话？此诏虽假。
却比真的更真。我料定，此诏一旦颁布天下，定然是群贼胆丧，群雄奋起。嗯，是啊，是啊，是啊。好啊，好啊，好啊！人言曹孟德乃治世之能臣，乱世之奸雄。今日一见。
果然如此啊！多谢公路将军夸奖我，我不但替天子拟好了一道诏书，我还替咱们大伙儿拟好了讨贼方略。出洛阳之前，我已经屈身弑贼有半年多了。这半年多的时间里，我已经把西凉军、军力、粮饷供给。 强弱情况，摸得一清二楚。有了这些，我相信咱们就能胜券在握。大伙儿请看。
And look who's shown up to the party, and what I'm one of my most favorite parts is coming up here.
Hey!
It's Hua Xiong, dude. Ooh. Ooh. Now, before we continue, I like to base all the generals that I'm going to talk about on Romance of the Three Kingdoms 2. It's based on a 100 scale, out of a scale to 0 to 100. I'm going to basically have them based on three different things. It's going to be charm, intelligence, and war. And everything's going to be based on 100. Liu Bu, who we've already met, would be 100 war. Zhang Fei, Guan Yu, they are 99 war. So on and so forth. So when we meet people, I'm going to explain to you exactly how they are on the rating scale for everything, okay? It'll make things a lot easier. Hua Xiong here is a 91. He is a 91 on the war scale here, okay? Not very intelligent, not very charming, but powerful as hell. And that's how things are going to work out from this point on. If you have any questions on that, please feel free to leave them in the comments and I'll get right back to you about it, alright? So remember, three categories based on a 0 to 100 scale, 100 being the best. War, charm, intelligence. Cool? Cool. And Hua Qihong here, who has a 91, just showed up.
上的小子们，给我听好了！我是前将军华雄，奉相国之命，前来讨伐叛贼。如果你们谁能将曹操狗贼的头颅给我踢上来，我将免你们不死！报！报！禀盟主，董卓的前锋将军华雄带着西凉大军说要讨伐曹操，正在关前叫骂。
华雄何许人也？怎敢如此妄自？此人不可小视，他是关西人士，号称董卓麾下的第四员猛将。And
Dong Zhuo has four main commanders here, okay? Ready? And he's the fourth. Hua Xiong at 91 is number four. The first is Liu Bu with a war of 99. Li Ju and Guo Xi. And they're both like early 80s, late 70s. But they've just been around longer. So it goes Hu Qing, Li Zhuo, Guo Xi, Liu Bu.
Liu Bei 将军, 我等刚刚聚义, 西凉军就来挑战, 这次是我军和董贼的首战, 此战, 要求必须斩将立功, 以壮我盟军的天威。
Look.
末将请求出战,
Guan Yu. Guan Yu wanted to step in, and Liu Bei stopped him. Let's get a rewind on that. That's perfect. Look at them. Look at them. Look at them. Ready? Here we go. And Wan Chu's general stepped up.
蒙德, 接着说你的方略吧。
好。 西凉军。
Fucking things up galore, dude. So, that's some good shit, dude, if you really, really think about it, dude. So, what do you guys think about it, dude? You got Cao Cao inviting Liu Bei to the party, which is nice to see. You have Zhang Fei calling everybody out. You have Guan Yu wanting to step up and take on Hua Xiong, the fourth ranked general in Dong Zhuo's army. And Liu Bei stopped his ass. He's like, nope, don't do it. So Yuan Shao, the cousin of Yuan Shao, the leader, his top general, he was like, here, set his ass out. So they went out, dude. Homeboy got snapped right away, dude. One bout, dude. Homeboy said he could do it in 10. You didn't even last one bout, homie. And that's where we're going to leave our episode, dude. That's crazy, dude. Homeboy is fucked up, dude. And Guan Yu can't take him on. It's fucked up, dude. Give Guan Yu a chance. Guan Yu, Guan Yu, Guan Yu, Guan Yu. All right, guys, dude. That was fun tonight, dude. I had a blast with y'all. If you like what you saw, like what you heard, please like and subscribe. If you have anything you want to comment about or talk about, dude, please leave them in the comments. I'd love to talk about things, dude. Talk about Three Kingdoms all day. We can talk about the video games. We can talk about the books. We can talk anything you want. So, I love y'all. Be good, be safe, be wise. Come back here, dude. We're going to be hit up and see what happens once Cthulhu Chong. Looks pretty fucking hard ass, dude, so we'll see what the scoop is, dude. Alright, guys, I had a bomb ass fucking time. It was a blast. God, I already said that shit. I'm gonna smoke too much. Alright, y'all, hit me up. Later.